everyone, and welcome back to Magically Me. It's been a while since I've been here because I've just been posting vlogs of me in the park, but welcome back. There's a lot more stuff on my wall since I was last here. And it's been really fun. I've been to the park about once a month, continuing up with seeing all the decorations and just experiencing the parks in new ways. There's a lot changing with Star Wars Galaxy's Edge coming into play, a lot of new construction, a lot of rumored things that are happening, so it's been really fun to keep up with the parks and see what's been going on. On today's video, I'm going to talk about the MaxPass in Disneyland. I've had a lot of people approach me because it's kind of confusing, and there's not really a lot online that tells you what MaxPass is actually about. So first of all, what is it? The MaxPass is a $15 addition to your park ticket that allows you to make FastPass selections on your mobile device. It also pays for all of your PhotoPass pictures for the entire day. So at $15 for all of your PhotoPass pictures, that's a really good deal. Especially because if you just buy the PhotoPass separately, it's about $40 for the whole day. So it's kind of a nice loophole that you know that you can pay $15 rather than $40. Even if you decide to not use the FastPass part of it, at least you can use the PhotoPass part of it and get really cheap pictures. In order to use your MaxPass, you have to be checked into the park. Unfortunately, unlike Disney World, you can't reserve FastPasses ahead of time. You actually have to physically check your park ticket in and reserve the FastPasses the day of. Once you're into the park and you book your first FastPass, at the bottom of the page on the app, you'll get some information that tells you when you're allowed to book your next FastPass. I've seen any amount of time range from about a half an hour to an hour and 30 minutes and beyond that. On a slower day, you can book a FastPass every 30 minutes, basically, and that's really awesome. There's no limitations on your FastPasses. You just have to follow the amount of time that they give you, and then you're allowed to make another one. If you buy the Park Hopper ticket also, you're allowed to make fast passes for both parks, which is pretty nice. So you don't have to go all the way back to Disneyland if you're in the middle of California Adventure to make a fast pass for Space Mountain. So that makes it really convenient and you save your feet a little bit because you don't have to walk like 5 more miles. Unfortunately, not all rides offer fast passes, and a bigger unfortunately is now Galaxy's Edge will not include MaxPass. If you want to wait in those really long lines, then go for it, but you won't be able to get a MaxPass for the foreseeable future, which is crazy. They're anticipating so many people being in Galaxy's Edge. That's probably why. Yeah, you'll have to wait in line. Just recently, it was also announced that you can now book fast passes for the two evening shows, World of Color and Fantasmic. You used to have to walk up to a kiosk and put your park ticket in, and then you get a little card that said which area of the reserved space you were allowed to sit in. But now, luckily, you can do that through your phone and not have to walk all the way to the kiosks to do that. And that's a really nice addition, again, to make it easier on your feet, easier on your day, make it more convenient for you, so that's pretty awesome. Alright, so now that I've told you what MaxPass is and what it includes, I'm gonna go into some tips that have really, really helped me throughout the years of navigating through the parks and making the most of my day. First thing is if you're in a big group of people, or even a small group of people, have one person link all of your park tickets together through the app so that you can all get the same MaxPass time for all your fast passes throughout the day. That's better than all of you having your own tickets on your phone, all of you trying to navigate through the app and trying to guess what times you can all get at the same time. It's really nice to put all of your group together in the same app on the same phone and even just have one person go through the app and book your fast passes for you. Another tip is to bring a portable charger. Going off of that, if you're the appointed person for all the fast passes, then your phone will die pretty quickly. I usually turn my phone on low power mode so that I can still browse Instagram and whatever. It's better than going on airplane mode, but it's always nice to have a portable charger so that when you can make fast passes, your phone isn't running out of battery super quickly. I think one of the biggest tips that I can tell you is that as soon as you enter the park, make sure you book a fast pass for one of the busiest rides. Fast passes will sell out through the day, and you'll probably know that even if you've gotten the paper fast passes or gone to Disney World, it's the same thing. If you book a fast pass at one time, there's only a limited amount of people that can get that time slot, and then they start to sell out throughout the day. I've been at the park when it's really, really busy, and Radiator Springs Racer has been sold out within an hour. Make sure that you kind of prioritize with your group, and as soon as you enter, book one of the busier rides. In California Adventure, those include Cars Radiator Springs Racers, Guardians of the Galaxy, Toy Story Midway Mania, and Incredicoaster. Those are the ones that are the most popular and typically run out of Fast Passes the quickest. In Disneyland, you have Space Mountain, Splash Mountain, Big Thunder Mountain, and that's about really it. Splash Mountain, it depends on the weather. If you're on a really, really hot and busy day, that'll probably sell out super quickly. So if you want to get a little refresher and you want to go on Splash Mountain, then be sure to book that one ahead of time before it sells out. I also love to set an alarm for the time that the FastPass gives me to book my next one. At the end of the day, I have about 50 alarms that have passed, but it's really helpful to really maximize your time and to get the most out of your MaxPass. And one of the last tips I have is to screenshot your park ticket on your phone or have your park ticket available as soon as you walk up to the FastPass line to check your ticket in. It's one of my biggest pet peeves when people walk up to the scanner for the FastPass and look really, really confused as to what they're doing. And I get it, if you're new to it, that makes sense, but that causes a huge backup in the FastPass line, and it's kind of frustrating for people who are kind of ahead of the game and know that you have to have your ticket readily available. Again, for the sake of your battery, it's nice to screenshot your park ticket on your phone and just pull it up in your pictures rather than having to open it with phone service and kill your battery later, or just have your paper ticket or your annual pass with you. And that's pretty nice to have too. Just have it available as soon as you walk up so you can quickly scan it and make the FastPass line move really smoothly. And finally, if you are an annual pass holder, you have the option to add on your MaxPass throughout the entire year. It's an additional $70 fee. Actually, it might be $90 now. Don't fact check me on that. But it's really worth it. So every time you enter the park, you're able to make any FastPass selection and not pay $15 every time you enter the park, which is what I did last year. I made the mistake of not adding that onto my park ticket. So it ended up being pretty expensive. Every time I was in the park, especially with friends, I'd want to buy the MaxPass. So it was basically $10 every time I went to Disney. And now they bumped it up even higher to $15. So I can't even imagine, like, that would go by really, really quickly, especially if you're an annual pass holder. And I definitely love having all the PhotoPass pictures, even if we didn't use the fast passes. Like I said before, it's just really nice to have all your PhotoPass pictures for really cheap. Is it worth it? And my answer is, oh my gosh, 100% worth it. It makes life so much easier. You save your feet, you just organize your day better, and it makes everybody coordinated, and it's just the best. For $15, I know it can kind of seem like a lot when you first buy it, but it's the most worth it thing I could tell you to do. Especially on busy days, it's easier to look at what's gonna sell out first and organize your day, like, oh, we could go here because this is a shorter line, let's get a fast pass for this. And then you make the most of your day. You get to ride the most rides, and yeah, it's just, it's really, really, really worth it. So be sure to add on that $15 pass next time you're in the park. Give it a try and tell me what you think. Well, that's all I have today. Hopefully I didn't forget anything. If you have any more additional questions about the MaxPass or PhotoPass or how to make the most of it, if I can think of anything that I didn't include in this video, just shoot me a message. You can email me, find me on Instagram, Facebook. I would be happy to answer any of your questions. But besides that, good luck if you're going into the parks, and I'll see you all there.